Good morning and welcome again. So in this class we will take some example problems and we will try to solve them. So first we will consider so one problem. So this problem says that you have been given one governing partial differential equation. So the equation is given in this form: A into dou phi by dou t equals to B into dou square phi by dou x square. So here in this case phi depends on x and t. So phi is the dependent variable, x and t are the independent variables, and A and B are the constants. You have been asked to determine the nature of this equation and give a set of boundary conditions that may be applied to this governing differential equation. So if you closely observe this equation, A dou phi by dou t equals to B dou square phi by dou x square is nothing but it is the one dimensional steady state heat conduction equation. So which says that dou t by dou t equals to 1 by alpha dou square t by dou x square. So if you compare these two equations, you will get this phi is nothing but the temperature T, which depends on the space x and the time t. So first you need to find out the nature of this equation. So for this you have to write down the generalized governing differential equation. Okay, so the generalized governing differential equation is A into dou square phi by dou x square plus B into dou square phi by dou x dou y plus C into dou square phi by dou y square plus d into dou phi by dou x plus e into dou phi by dou y plus f into phi equals to g. Let us say you have one differential equation of this form, and here in this case, so you find out the value of b square minus 4a into c. So that means you take these coefficients A, coefficient B and this coefficient C, and you try to find out B square minus 4AC, and if this value is less than 0, okay, so you have three possibilities. You can have this value that can be a negative number, or this value can be a positive number, and this value you can get to be equal to 0. So depending on whether this b square minus 4ac is equals to 0 or greater than 0 or less than 0, you will be able to decide the nature of this governing differential equation. So when this b square minus 4ac is less than 0, you call it is elliptic in nature, and when this equals to 0, you call it parabolic, and whenever this is greater than 0, you call it is hyperbolic. Okay. So here in this case, if you compare the expression given to us with this generalized expression, you will get this A equals to, you will get B, then B equals to 0 and C equals to 0. Okay. Then you see here the value of D, E, F and G, they does not play any role in deciding the nature of this equation. So that is why we are also not interested to find the values of D, E, F and G. Okay. So from here you will see A is B, B is some constant, so it is a positive number, then B and C equals to 0. So if you put these values here, you will get this will be 0 minus 4 into B into 0. So that will be again you will get 0. So that means here for this case you will get B square minus 4AC equals to 0. That means this is the nature of this governing differential equation given to you is parabolic in nature. Then second thing, you have been asked to find out or write the boundary conditions applicable to this problem. Okay. So as I said you, so this expression is nothing but it represents your one dimensional unsteady heat conduction in a solid domain. So you can write down here you require two number of conditions for the x direction and one condition for the time t. So this boundary conditions you can write down. Okay. So here first will be, let us say you consider a one dimensional domain. So, here this phi is varying with x and also varies with the time t. Okay. So, the domain will extend, let us say it extends from x equals to 0 to x is equals to, let us say L, where L is the domain width. Then you can write down when x is equals to 0, the phi will have some value, then x is equals to L, the phi will have some value. So, here you can assume that key initially this object was at a particular temperature, uniform temperature throughout the domain, then suddenly you dipped into another fluid medium where you can maintain the temperature on the two surfaces to have some constant value. So, let us say you can write down this constant values. Okay. Then you can see initially it was having some temperature. So, you can write down from time t 0 phi equals to, let us say, t naught. So, this will be the boundary conditions that will be concerned to this equation given to us. Clear? Okay, so next we will go for solving another problem, problem number 2. This problem number 2 states that for the numerical solution of one dimensional transient diffusion problem governed by dou phi by dou t equals to a into dou square phi by dou x square, the explicit Euler method is to be used. So, that means the governing differential equation is given to you and it is also mentioned that you have to use the explicit Euler method for solving this problem. Okay. So, first you write down the governing differential equation given to us, that is dou phi by dou t equals to a into dou square phi by dou x square. Okay. And here you have to use the explicit Euler method. Okay. Then if the grid size delta x is taken as 0.1 meter, that is delta x is given as 0.1, find the maximum time step that may be employed for stable numerical scheme. And here in this case the value of a is given, that is 10 to the power minus 6 meter square per second. Okay. Then second part of the question says, find the limitation on the time step if the grid size is reduced from 0.1 to 0.01 meter. So, next we will consider 0.01 meter. Okay. So, first you will go for the discretization of this problem, and here for the purpose of discretization we will use the explicit Euler method. Okay. So, here for this dou phi by dou t we will use a forward difference. So, it will be phi at I at time step p plus 1 minus phi at I at time step p divided by delta t, that is equals to a into discretization of dou square phi by dou x square will become phi at I minus 1 minus 2 into phi at I plus phi at I plus 1, and here all the three terms will be at the time step p. So, here in this case you will see right hand side all the three phi values are calculated at the time step p, left hand side you have two values of phi, one is at time step p plus 1, another is at time step p. So, overall there is only one term phi where it is calculated time step p plus 1, otherwise all the terms of phi are calculated at the time step p. So, that is why you keep this term only on one side and you take everything to the other side. So, you can rewrite it, phi at I at the time step p plus 1 will be equals to phi at I at the time step p plus a into delta t by delta x square into phi at I minus 1 minus 2 into phi at I plus phi at I plus 1, and all the terms are calculated the time step p. Okay. So, here we can write down this term A delta T by delta x square to be equals to beta. So, you write down here beta equals to A into delta T by delta x square, and which should be less than equals to 0.5 to get a stable solution. So, this you can say the condition of stability. Okay. So, the question says that if delta x is taken as 0.1 meter, find the maximum time step that may be employed for a stable numerical scheme. So, that means from here you need to find out what should be the value of delta t, biggest value of or maximum value of delta t, so that you will get a stable solution. So, from here you will get delta t less than equals to 0.5 into delta x square by A, and here the value of delta x is given as 0.1 and the value of delta, sorry, A is given as 10 to the power minus 6. So, that you put it here. So, you will get delta t should be less than equals to 0.5 into 0.1 square divided by 10 to the power minus 6. So, that comes out to be 0.5 is 1 by 2 into 10 to the power minus 6. This becomes your 10 to the power minus 2. So, what remains here? At the top you will get 10 to the power 4 divided by 2. So, 10,000 by 2, this comes your 5,000. So, you check the calculation again. So, that means the maximum time step that may be employed for a stable solution comes out to be 5,000, because delta t should be less than equals to 5,000. So, 5,000 is also valid, and that is why 5,000 is the maximum value that you can consider. Actually, here you see in this process to get the solution for this question, these steps is not required at all, if you remember this formula. Okay. So, only to make you remind only I wrote this expressions here, otherwise it is not required. Then we will go to the part 2 of the question, which says that instead of delta x 0.1, if we use delta x 0.01, what should be the value of time step. So, again we repeat the same thing. So, here you will get delta t should be less than equals to 0.5 into delta x, now comes out to be 0.01 square divided by A. A is remain same, 10 to the power minus 6 only. So, this way you will get 2 into 10 to the power minus 6, this will become 10 to the power minus 4. So, this 10 to the power 4, 10 to the power 4 will cancel. So, bottom you will have 10 to the power minus 2, it will go to up, 10 to the power 200 divided by 2 will be 50. So, we will get delta t should be less than equals to 50. So, instead of using delta x, that is grid spacing 0.1 meter, if you are going for a finer grid, that is 0.01 meter, then you need to consider relatively smaller time step. You see, earlier it was 5000 seconds, now it comes out to be maximum value you can take is 50 seconds only. That means you need to calculate either at 50 second interval or a time step which should be less than 50 seconds. Clear? Okay. So, next we will go for problem number 3. Problem number 3 says that one dimensional conduction in a rod of length L is governed by the equation is given to you, that is 1 by alpha dou t by dou t equals to dou square t by dou x square minus h into t minus t a. So, here in this case t a is the ambient temperature, small t is the time, and capital T is the temperature, which is function of x and time t. Then the question says that at time t equals to 0, the temperature at the two ends are raised to 100 degree centigrade. So, first you will go for the diagram. Let us say this is the domain, total length is L. So, it is x is equals to 0 and this is x is equals to L, and here we maintain this temperature 100. here also you maintain the temperature of 100, T is function of x and T here, and there is heat transfer by means of convection. Okay. So, normally we use this heat transfer coefficient small h. So, here things are given in a little bit compact form. It says that this capital H is your, the value is given to you, it is 100 meter inverse, and where this H is the heat loss parameter, and this value of ambient temperature T A is given, that is 15 degree centigrade. So, it will be 273 plus 15, 288 Kelvin. Okay. Then value of this alpha is given, that is 10 to the power minus 6 meter square plus second, and this length is given as 0.4 meter, this total length, delta x is given as 0.04 meter. So, this indicates that L is 4 meter, delta x is 0.4 meter. So, number of divisions n, it will be L by delta x. So, which will comes out to be 10 divisions. So, 10 divisions means in total there will be 11 number of grid points. So, if you start dividing here, so it will start from I is equal to 1 on the left face corresponding to x is equals to 0, and it will extend up to I is equals to 11, which corresponds to the right face at x is equals to L. Clear? Okay. So, here you have to find out, you have been asked to use any suitable numerical method and solve this problem. So, solve this problem means you have to find out the temperature distribution inside the domain. So, here in this case you go for discretizing this problem. So, first you will go for the discretization. So, here you can consider it will be T I at P plus 1 minus T I at P divided by delta T into alpha equals to, on the right hand side you will get T I minus 1 minus 2 T I plus T I plus 1, all the terms are at the time step P divided by delta x square minus H into discretization of T will be T I minus T A. So, T A is a constant. Okay. So, you here you are having this term at the time step p plus 1, and all the terms are calculated at the time step p. So, here also there will be a time step p. So, you keep this on left hand side, you take everything to the right hand side. So, you will get T I p plus 1 equals to T I p plus alpha delta T y delta x square into, inside bracket you will get T I minus 1 P minus 2 T I P plus T I plus 1 P minus. So, this alpha delta T will also be multiplied with the second term also here. So, you will get H into alpha delta T into, you will get T I P, we will open the bracket here because we need to simplify this. So, minus minus will be plus. Again you will get H alpha delta T into T A. Okay. So, we will again rewrite this one. So, you will get here T I P plus 1 equals to, so first you write down T I minus 1 P. So, T I minus 1 P, there is only one term, that is multiplied with alpha delta T by delta x square. So, you can write down this to be equals to beta. Okay. So, you will get beta into T I minus 1 into P, then plus you will get 1 minus 2 beta. So, here it is TIP. So, there is also a TIP here. So, TIP will come on. So, we will get 1 minus 2 into beta. Then there is another TIP here. Okay. So, let us say we will take this again another constant. You can suppose write down, suppose this is to be gamma. So, you can write down. So, it will be minus gamma into TIP plus again beta TI plus 1 P. Then remains here is again your alpha delta T into TA. So, this again if you calculate it will come out to be again some constant value. Let it you write down to be this equals to C. C is a constant. So, this is the discretized form of the governing differential equation. Then you need to rewrite this expression at all the 11 grid points. Okay, so here in this case you see this is in the, if you consider this to be from the present time step, this all these terms of T is in the from the previous time step. So, here we will start from the initial condition and go on calculating. So, you can form a table for solving this problem. So, here in a row you take the location value, that is the different value of I starting from 1 and it goes up to 11 as per the information given here. So, take here 11 columns. So, it is 1, 2, 3, it goes up to 11. Then here in the downward direction, we will take the different time step values. So, here you create different rows here. So, initially the object was at a temperature of T ambient and suddenly you started maintaining a temperature of 100 on the left and the right face. So, whatever happened, and this ambient temperature is given to 15 degree centigrade, that means initially it was at a lower temperature, suddenly you maintained higher temperature on the left and the right face. That means heat will penetrate into the domain and slowly the temperature inside the domain will start rising with respect to time, and after a long time it will come into a steady state condition. And here our objective to see what will be the temperature at each and every point inside the domain with respect to time. So, that means initially it was everywhere T ambient. So, you write down that value, that is 15 degrees or 288 Kelvin. So, everywhere you will get 288. Then suddenly the left and right face was subjected to 100 degree centigrade. So, it will be 373 Kelvin. Every time step its value remains constant. So, here it is the left, that is I equals to 1, it is the right, I is equals to 11. So, every place of this column it will be 373. Okay, next you need to use this expression to fill this table. So, here you can consider, you see when you take P equals to 0, that means T at different values of phi, initially everywhere it is 288 only. So, this will be 288, this is 288 and this is 288. Okay. Then this values of beta and gamma and C, that needs to be calculated, so that you can calculate the values starting from I is equals to 2 up to I is equals to 10 in the next time step, that is P plus 1. So, what is the difference between P and P plus 1? That is equal to delta T, that is the time step that we need to decide, because depending on the value of delta T we will select, the solution may be a stable or it may be unstable solution. So, to obtain the stable solution, we need to recall the condition of stability. The condition of stability says that the value of beta, that is equals to alpha delta T by delta x square. Okay, and here as per this, this should be less than equals to 0.5, and here the value of alpha is given to be 10 to the power minus 6. So it is 10 to the power minus 6 into delta t divided by delta x square. So grid spacing is given to be 0.04 meter. So its square is less than or equal to 0.5. So that means you will get delta t less than or equal to 0.5 into 0.04 square divided by 10 to the power minus 6. So this comes out to be here, it is at the bottom you will get 2, at the top you will get 10 to the power 6, then it will be 16, then at the bottom you will get 10 to the power 4. So if you simplify this calculation, you will get delta t should be less than equals to 800. So please check the calculation again. So delta t comes out to be less than equals to 800. So you can consider this value, or you can consider another value of delta t which is less than 800. Let us say we will consider delta t equals to 400. So if you consider delta t equals to 400, then again you need to calculate what will be the value of beta you will get here. Okay. Suppose we will say, let us take beta equals to 400, delta t. Then corresponding to this, what will be the value of this beta we will get? 10 to the minus 6 into 400 divided by 0.04 square. Okay, so you do this calculation. So you will get 400 divided by 10 to the power 6 into 16 into 10 to the power 4. So you will get 10 to the power 4 to 10 to the power 6, 10 to the power 6 will cancel, 4 by 16, 1 by 4, 0.25. So value of beta comes out to be 0.25. So now we will rewrite the discretized form of this governing differential equation. So here you got pi p plus 1 equals to 0.25 into pi minus 1 p plus 1 minus 2 into beta, beta 0.25, so it comes out to 0.5. So 1 minus 0.5 minus gamma, so the value of gamma you need to find out here again. What is the expression for gamma? Gamma was alpha delta t h. Okay, then c equals to alpha delta t h into t a. Okay. So alpha is 10 to the minus 6, delta t we consider 400 and h is given to be 100. So you will get 4 into 10 to the power minus 2, that is 0.04. Then c comes out to be alpha delta t h is again gamma only. So we can use this value directly, 0.04 into t a. T a is 15 degree centigrade, that is 288 Kelvin. So you calculate this value, 288 into 0.04. So we get 11.52. Okay. So that you can write down here, it is minus gamma, gamma comes out to be 0.04. Okay. It is TIP plus 0.25 TI plus 1 P plus C. C comes out to be 11.52. Okay. So this expression we have to use here now to fill this table. So now here you can rewrite this for I corresponding to 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10 here. So when I is equals to 2, you write this expression. So you will get T 2 P plus 1 is equals to 0.25 into T 1 P plus, here you will get this is 0.5 and 0.04. So it is 0.54, 1 minus 0.54 you will get 0.46 T 2 P plus again 0.25 T 3 P plus 11.52. Similarly, you write down for 3, you will get T 3 P plus 1 will be 0.25 T 2 P plus 0.46 T 3 P plus 0.25 T 4 P plus 11.52. Like this you write up to I equals to 10. So once you write this expressions, then you have to use them here to fill this column. For example, let us say you take I equals to 2. So this is the expression. So here I equals to 2. So we need to fill this information here. So that means this is equals to this value T 2 P plus 1. This value will come here. And for this purpose, you require T 1, T 2 and T 3 at the time step P. P means its previous time step. So this is your T 1, this is T 2 and this is T 3. So that means you multiply 288 divided by 0.25, then you multiply this 288 by 0.46 and you multiply this 288 by 0.25. You add them together and whatever value you will get, again you add by 11.52, that value you will get it here. So that means here you will get 0.25 into 288 plus again 0.46 into 288 plus 0.25 into 288. So these things will be inside brackets, each bracket plus 11.52. So you calculate them. What is the value comes out? So you check and tell me. You will see this value will be definitely greater than 288 and it will be less than this value of 373. What is the value you are getting? So you see, so you will get here 288 into 0.25, 0.25 is 0.5 plus 0.46, that is 0.96. 288 into 0.96, which will be slightly less than 288 plus 11.52. 288 exactly you are getting. Okay. So 288. Similarly, you go on calculating. So if you are getting exactly 288, this indicates that steel heat is not penetrated up to this point. So if you take steel finer grids in between them, then you will see that let's say we will take again 5 grids in between them. So here we consider 10 divisions. Suppose instead of 10 you take 50 divisions. So up to the 5th division, which is now the second value here, heat is not penetrated, but when you take 50 division you will be able to see the difference. That means first value is 373, second value will be slightly greater than 288. Okay, like this. Slowly you will see these values will go on increasing and you can go for a plot for this information that you get here. Let us say we will go for a two dimensional plot for this case here. So here you take the location x and here you take the temperature T in the y direction. Okay. So initially everywhere 288. So you can draw, let us say this is the 288 value and suppose this is the value 373. Okay. So initially everywhere it was 288, so you will get 11 points like this here. Then in the next moment suddenly left and right face become 373. So this becomes 373, this becomes 373, but as per this calculation, if you take try to plot it, here it is still 288. That means at the next points same value only. So it will, you will get like this only. So this will be like this. Then again you calculate the next table here. So at the next moment, you may get this value slightly higher, okay? And this, let's say assume that it is still not affected, so it will, you will get like this. Clear? Sorry, it will join here. Then in the next moment again it will go up. So like this, you will see the temperature profiles you will get here. Then after a long time, infinite time, you will see everywhere the temperature will be same as the temperature on the boundary, that is 100 degree centigrade or 373 Kelvin. So this curve tells you the steady state temperature distribution. And this remaining curves, they tell you the temperature varying with time t in addition to the temperature varying with space x. So here these are t is function of x and t. So as you move here in this direction, the time t is increasing and this corresponds to t equals to infinity. And if you try to convert them into contour form also, then also you can do, and in that case you will be able to create an animation. So if you consider the domain, because for one dimensional you will not be able to get a contour, so you need to take two dimensional information. So you can consider some length along the second direction for the purpose of the contour, then each every time step the values of temperature is changing along the direction, that is why in the contour it will change in the form of color. So you will be able to create an animation which will show slowly the temperature is increasing. So if you consider the lowest temperature to be blue and the highest temperature to be red, you will see slowly the temperature inside the domain is changing from blue towards the red, and finally after long time it will remain only red only. That indicates that the higher temperature is acquired and you are in the steady state condition. Clear? Okay, thank you. We will continue in the next class.